bien, ¿cómo te sientes?
Muy bien, la verdad, sí. Muy contento porque estoy aquí con ustedes, practicando mi deporte favorito.
My friend Brian, lost your leg 3 years ago for motorcycle accident.
All-Ramp is a nonprofit. What we do and our mission is to ensure high quality prosthetic care to underserved people so we can help them to improve their mobility and independence. Why do we exist? It's because in the world there are a lot of people with no access to high technology prosthetic care. And that is just something that shouldn't happen.
Because this goes on the outside. Or that goes on the inside.
My grandfather did a lot of woodworking. My dad was a mechanic. We didn't like to pay for things to get fixed. We just fixed them. I grew up with that mindset of trying to understand how things work just in case they break and I have to fix it. Ideally, I'd like to work my way up to being a prosthetist. I really like the concept of working with people, making their sockets, fitting it, and doing essentially everything that I've been doing here. Joshua was born with a congenital birth defect in his foot, so he was born without a foot and without most of his shin. If I didn't know that he was missing his foot, he was just like any other kid. He's adapted to his life with this difference. We'd be like, all right, kick a ball, and he'd kick it with the other foot, and we'd be like, no, with the other foot. He was playing around with us a little bit.
Haven't had a chance to work with prosthetics before because of being a neuroscience undergraduate, so I'm learning about how to measure, how to form, what bones to watch out for, because there are several bones in the leg that we have to actually adapt for and build recesses for.
Bastante inestabilidad con esta, entonces estoy esperando con ansias la nueva. Ayer me sentí muy alegre y muy especial porque al ver bastantes estudiantes el día de ayer que estén aprendiendo conmigo y con Mireya que me está haciendo lo de la prótesis fue como muy, muy divertido para mí. Así.
¿Qué te pasó con tu pierna?
Tuve un accidente de tránsito cuando era chiquita. Un bus me pasó a mí y a mi mamá.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Pero yo perdí la pierna.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Joanna was really, she was a really cool case for me. I had a really big part in making her device. When we were able to present it to her, I was able to say like, hey, from me to you, here's this thing.
Tengo muchas emociones bien bonitas.
I really like this environment of being able to give someone something back that was taken from them. Trying to do powerlifting stuff, to have this really nice, really fancy piece of equipment, kind of knowing her personality a little bit, I think she's gonna take this and run, literally. I'm hoping to see her in Olympics.
we are sending people to Mars, and it's just incredible that we cannot have a decent knee and a decent foot for someone that wants to do something that everyone should do, that is walk. That is what we are providing Joanna, and not only this year, but until she's able to provide for herself.
With Brian, that was so much fun. Like, he was so enthusiastic the entire time, like getting his prosthetic.
Smile got like bigger throughout the week.
Soy un estudiante en Colorado. Soy estudiando como los ciencias de ejercicio.
Hi, I'm Soraya. I'm also a student with Colorado State University, and I'm studying chemical and biological engineering.
I wanted to go into more of a health profession with athletic training.
Aprieta un poquito, apretado. Compresión.
Being able to have an athlete have an injury and help them get from that lowest point to like that highest point.
Y acá un poquito más de presión con estos. Así, hacer estos. Eso.
He got a low-cost prosthetic, but it was made out of wood. It was very uncomfortable, so he actually had a lot of health issues. We were chatting, and I asked him, where are you in your career? Are you almost done? Because he's 23, and he said, like, he had so many health issues at the university, I actually asked him to drop out, because he was taking too much time off because of medical reasons.
Que, o sea, nunca yo he sentido que fracturas ni nada de eso. Fue mi primera vez desde caída en moto y la última.
We're just like adding plaster to make the perfect concentration so it can go in the mold.
Now this is almost a perfect copy of the stump of the patient. Rump operates year-round, right? But on average, they do 10 to 12 prostheses a month. Because our students are here because of our cohort, we are delivering out 25 on a week.
It's really special for each of the prosthetics. They're able to pick a pattern or a design to put on their prostheses. And the one that's really special about that one is he picked dinosaurs for his son, because he said his son loved dinosaurs. With this new prosthetic, he'll be able to have knee mobility as well as be able to walk normally.
Yeah!
We're cleaning the parts to get all like any excess dust and stuff off of it. So they're actually like recycled from donations from either like clinics or people who have outgrown or have upgraded their prosthetics from America usually.
Yes. Marlon hasn't walked in 11 years, and he was telling us how his family was hitchhiking across the continent. I think they just happened to be in Ecuador for this amount of time, and seeing like the children from their neighborhood like come together, and they were all excited for this moment.
He felt like a little kid. He was learning and taking his first steps again.
Muy bien. Ahora, vamos a bajar.
I don't know if I'm processing it really.
Yeah.
I can't imagine how he must be feeling after 11 years. I think it's just, and it came so quickly too.
A lot of young patients, they go through very, very deep processes like depression, anxiety. They don't want to go out. They don't want to go and participate in the spaces that they used to participate, like go to college, continue working, or sometimes they are fired from their jobs because people think that they aren't going to be able to work again.
Feliz. Muy feliz.
Five or six of us, they're really now considering going to this field. So I think this trip has really opened their eyes about like what the field is and the real impact they have with people.
Do you hope to play soccer again?
Claro, pues. Le voy a dedicar un gol. Claro.
This is such a rare opportunity to be so young and be in our education this early and then come to different places and have different experiences that form us to be better people.
We were chatting and apparently he's in class now. This is his second part of his first semester. So he's missing class just to come and get his prosthetic. So now that he has it, he's going back to work, he's going back to study. So that was just incredible.
Me han pasado así literalmente cosas impresionantes, como que una vez estuve a punto de ahogarme. Cuando nací, andaba en un andador y me caí de unas escaleras cuando estoy andador. Entonces como que qué miedo lo que me ha pasado, pero qué suerte porque estoy vivo y estoy aquí en el mundo y puedo conocerlas a todos ustedes.